Hey y'all, it's Vanessa with Farm Girl Gardens and Market. It is bright and sunny out here, y'all, so I'm gonna be making all kinds of faces at you. But we're harvesting our onions. These onions were grown with intention for the North Texas Food Bank, and they are to benefit the Allen Community Outreach. And so if you are a local and you have a desire to help grow food for those in need, then please continue to subscribe and follow along, because the heart and intention of all of this farm project is so that we can grow food sustainably, not only for ourselves, but for our neighbors in need. And now, especially during these days of COVID, people are hurting and they're hungry. If you have a patch of land, you should do something with it, and I hope you grow. And what we're growing today and harvesting today are onions. Onions, in Texas, you really do have to kind of space your harvesting around the rain. We had a bunch of rain last week. I took a chance because I was having a baby and leaving them in the ground. Now that was a risk, but thankfully, I've got some help out here today. We're gonna get these out of the ground and get them over to the food bank, and they are just fine. But what you wanna do with your onions when you're harvesting, you're looking for signs that they're ready. Signs that they're ready are yellowing of leaves, like we have here, and also that the skin itself on the onion is starting to harden up and form that paper skin like you would see at the store. Hopefully you guys can see what I'm pointing to, because I'm shooting this blind right now. But what you're gonna do is you're gonna come in, and just like we've been doing throughout the entire grow season, removing the soil around the base of the onion, you're gonna do that with your finger, and then hold the bulb. You can either do it from higher up on the neck, or if you're gentle with the bulb, you can do it here. But we're just wriggling this guy out. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna take all the soil off of the root, being careful not to touch the skin. We don't want to compromise the integrity of that onion skin, but we're really just removing the soil off of this root ball. And then what we're going to do is we're actually going to take these inside to the cellar. We're going to lay them out to dry them so that they can cure. This is about a 2-day process. The time is not the critical component. It's what's happening to the plant. We are looking for this neck to dry up a little, and we are looking for this papery skin to further develop into a paper shield. Once that occurs, you're going to come in and you're going to cut the greens off right about here on this onion. The reason for that is if you cut it too small or too close to the bulb, it's just going to create a wound that won't cure, and then your onions will rot on you. Cut them up here higher on the neck about 2 days into the drying process, and then let it dry overnight. That neck will shrink down and seal off the onion, keeping the sugars stored and keeping it from deteriorating or rotting on you. And then once that's done, you're going to come in and you're going to cut off the roots of this. I'm going to clean this guy up a little bit more, but you're going to cut up the roots. So first you're looking for signs that they're done with the greens dying off and yellowing, the paper on the onion starting to develop. You will pull them all out, let them cure in a dark and dry environment for about 2 days, or until you start to see those indications with the neck shriveling and the skin forming. Then you'll cut the neck again right here, wait about another day, and then go ahead and trim off your roots. Once you've done that, those onions are cured and ready to go in your cupboard for storage. If you do want to venture into onion braiding, I will provide a second video on that later on this week, hopefully. And that's all that I want to say about onions. We're going to go ahead and get these guys out of the ground and over to the food bank. I hope that you guys are well, and until next time, happy growing, y'all.